I want to address the subject of diabetes, and it is a very serious problem in our society today. Over 25 million Americans have been diagnosed with diabetes, and 7 million people don't even know that they have it. Although that might not seem like such a large number in the big picture, over the years, the number has risen extensively. Many of you might not even know what diabetes does to you. After you eat or drink, your body breaks down sugar in your blood and turns it into glucose. The glucose then travels through your bloodstream and provides energy to your body. To do this, the pancreas needs to produce a hormone called insulin, and in a person with diabetes, insulin is either not produced, produced too little, or cannot be used effectively. And with this, with insulin without being produced, blood pressure rises this allows blood sugar levels to rise while the rest of your cells are deprived of much needed energy. This can lead to a wide variety of symptoms from diabetes, including pancreatic malfunction, thirst, heart disease, foot problems, and the possibility of strokes. Now, what I'm about to show you is an example of foot problems that can happen with diabetes. And it is quite disturbing, the images. So if you have a queasy stomach, I would recommend looking away about now. So, this person has, as you can see here, this person is suffering from a quite an infection. It went from a little irritation on the skin to a full-blown infection in just 10 days due to high blood pressure in the leg and not enough blood getting to it. People are looking like him with that. So, naming all of these symptoms and talking about what diabetes can do to you, it just seems so familiar to me. Now, with me saying this, some of you may be thinking that I have diabetes. And if so, you would be correct in about 15 years. I have a very high chance of getting diabetes from my mother's side of the family. That's my mom right there, with my grandma and my uncle. See, my grandma has diabetes, and she is amazing, obviously, to my grandma. But she has diabetes, and with that comes the possibility of me getting it. So the reason I found out about this is because I asked my mom when I was around 10 if why she was always forcing me to go outside and do something or play a sport, like soccer. She was always forcing me to do stuff like that. And she was always so picky also on what foods I would eat. She wouldn't even let me have like Oreos or Cinnabon. Okay, I don't recommend eating that though. That's disgusting. It's 1500 calories in one thing, so. And you kind of get fat from just eating one Oreo, I would say. Or just me sitting around and watching an hour of TV. To me, holding this information for me was a mistake. From holding that for me, I didn't know what was going on, and I just was craving much more of this food. So I didn't want it, I just wanted Oreos. I just wanted to sit around and watch TV. For her to keep something like that for me, I just felt betrayed and walked on. And like I said, it just made me want to do the things that she prevented me from doing more. When she told me that I have the chance of diabetes, I completely changed. I wanted to find a way to keep myself healthy and do other things. I wanted to do other things, such as like running, eating healthier. But I didn't do that or try to do that until ninth grade. In ninth grade, I wanted to do cross country. That didn't work out. But sources that I have come across say that eating healthy and doing exercise are the main ways to go. I personally agree with this. Since I found out, like I said, I've tried to find a way to keep myself healthy, but from that point from 7th to 9th grade, I would say, that I wanted to try to do something healthy with my life. I didn't do anything. I just sat around and played video games, stayed inside most of the days, and just brought food to my room and did nothing. Now, in 10th grade, I found something of interest to me, because in 7th through 8th grade, I was in band. So, in 10th grade, I found out about marching band, and so I thought I would give that a shot, and and since then, I have been the healthiest I've been in my life, and I feel the best I have. So, when you have diabetes, you have to do many things to keep yourself in check. High blood sugar is a common effect of diabetes, and this means that you have to check your blood sugar levels constantly with a finger prick, which is nothing. And you have to take a bunch of pills and such, and shots to keep your body to help your body compensate with the insulin that isn't being produced. I've experienced the struggle of diabetes, the symptoms of diabetes, secondhand. I've experienced secondhand from my grandma. I see her mostly every day, and it pains me to see her do what she does, because her checking her blood sugar levels, pricking her finger, it just seems like a major inconvenience. And this inconvenience surfaces itself, such as, say we're having a family dinner. She is older, and her memory isn't what it used to be, so she sometimes forgets to take her pills. Now, she cannot eat without having her, without taking her pills, so sometimes she misses out on eating with the family, which is really disappointing because I love my grandma. To be completely honest, diabetes is not that bad of a disease compared to others if taken care of. To me, it is mainly an inconvenience to you and to others, and sometimes you're unable to participate in certain things such as riding a roller coaster due to high blood pressure, or small things, like I said, a family dinner. And to me, this is a lot worse than just doing a little exercise a day, little exercise and dieting a little bit every day. Now, diabetes might not be such a huge thing compared to things like cancer and cardiovascular disease, but in a couple of years, as shown by the numbers, it will be. Thank you.